here at the Greater Portmore Open Bible Church. We say welcome to you. I'm going to invite us to come forward, join us at the old-fashioned altar as we begin this morning worship service. Could you be kind enough just to journey from where you are to the altar this morning?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just want to be where you are, dwelling daily in your presence. I don't want to worship from afar. Draw me near to where you are. I want to be where you are, dwelling in your presence, feasting at your table, surrounded by your glory, Lord, in your presence. That's where I always want to be. I just want to be. I just want to be with you. I just want to be where you are, dwelling daily in your presence. I don't want to worship from afar. Draw me near to where you are. I want to be where you are, dwelling in your presence, feasting at your table, surrounded by your glory, Lord, in your presence. That's where I always want to be. I just want to be. I just want to be with you.
I just want to be.
I want to be where you are, dwelling in your presence, feasting at your table, surrounded by your glory. Just want to be with you.
Wanna be where you are,
dwelling in your presence, feasting at your table, surrounded by your glory, Lord, in your presence. That's where I always want to be. I just want to be. I just want to be with you.
Creating me a clean heart and purify me, purify me.
You created me a clean heart. Creating me a clean heart and purify me. Purify me. Creating me a clean heart so I may worship you. Cast me not away from your presence. Please don't take your spirit from me. And restore the joy of salvation so that I may worship you. Cast me not away from your presence. Please don't take your spirit from me. And restore the joy of salvation so that I may worship you. So that I may worship you. So that I may worship you. So that I may worship you.
I'm going to sing that song one
more time. Clean heart and purify me. Purify me. Create in me a clean heart so I may worship you. Cast me not so that I may worship you. So that I may worship you.
May return to see that we continue to sing that song.
Create in me a clean heart and purify me. Cast me not away from your presence. Please don't take your spirit from me. And restore the joy of salvation so that I may worship you. So that I may worship you. Hallelujah.
Praise be to our God. Praise be to God. You may be seated. Well, today is the Sunday before we celebrate Christmas. Falls on a Monday this year. But this morning is also Youth Sunday. So you will hear and see more of our young people. Our moderator this morning is our deaconess Raquel Humes. So we invite her to come along this night.
Good morning, church. Good morning, church. It's a season of rejoicing, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and he shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. Can we put our hands together for Jesus this morning? He is worthy of our praise. He's worthy of our glory. Hallelujah. The psalm says, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. And so we are here this morning to lift up the name of Jesus. He is worthy. He was born in a manger, but he's no longer in the manger, because he is now in heaven, seated at the right hand of the Father, and he's also making intercession for us, and he's going to come back one day for us. Can we put our hands together again for Jesus? He is Lord of Lords and King of Kings this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. At this time, I would like to invite the praise team with the opening hymn, Joy to the World. Praise team. Can we stand as the praise team comes to the podium? Thanks.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Joy to the world. The Lord is come. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Joy to the world. The Lord is come. Let us receive our King. Let every heart prepare a room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Let men their songs employ, while fields and floods, rocks and plain, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy.
Blessings flow far as the
joy to the world. Let us stand for intercessory prayer at this time. The Lord is come. Let us stand for intercessory prayer at this time. Thank you. Hallelujah. Are there any spoken requests? The family or nation? And any unspoken requests this morning? Yes, we all have something to tell the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not. Thy compassion they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Hallelujah. We thank you this morning. Lord, we worship you, mighty God. Lord, you are God and God alone. Lord, you are the King of kings. Lord, you are the Lord of lords. Lord, you are the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah. Lord, you are the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. Lord, you are the fairest of 10,000 to our souls. Lord, there is none like you. We search all over, Father, and we cannot find anyone to be compared to you, O Father. And so we give thanks this morning for being such an awesome God in all your ways. Lord, we thank you, O God, for everything that you have been doing for us, Lord, and what you are about to do in our lives this morning. Lord, I pray that you just create in us a clean heart and renew a right spirit within me, O God. Lord, may the words of my mouth this morning, O God, Lord, be, O God, acceptable in your sight this morning. Lord, I thank you for who you are this morning. And so I come to you, O God, on behalf of this land, Jamaica. Lord, I pray, O God, that, Lord, you do something new in this land, O God. Lord, we pray every day, O God, but Lord, you continue to say in your words, if my people who are called by my name, Lord, shall humble themselves and pray and seek your face, Lord, and turn from our wicked ways, Lord, then you'll hear from heaven this morning, Lord, and forgive our sins and heal our land, Lord, and no matter how many times we pray, oh God, we believe your words, Lord, that you'll do something new in this island home, Jamaica. Lord, I pray, oh God, that you touch the highways and the edges this morning, oh God. Lord, that you do something, oh God, for the young people of this island, oh God, the future. Lord God, I pray, oh God, that we just continue, oh God, to rise up in this land, oh God. Lord, not to be afraid of the gospel, oh God, but to go on these edges, oh God, even in this season, oh Father. Oh God, you know the devil is like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour this morning, oh God. But I pray, oh God, that you just cover us under your blood. Lord, that no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper, oh Father. Lord, I pray, oh God, that we just be under your wings, oh God. Your word reminds us, oh God, that you are our shield and our buckler, oh God. And so we depend upon you, oh God, that you do something mighty, oh God, through the government of Jamaica. Lord, that they'll seek you before they make decisions on our behalf, oh God. Lord, that they do the right thing, oh God, not to please men, oh God, but to please you, oh God, who is the author and the finisher of our faith this morning. Lord, I pray for families, oh God, the families represented in Jamaica. Oh God, I see the devil is trying to intercede in these families, oh God. Lord, I see where the mother killed her son, oh God, for whatever reason, oh Father. Lord, I pray, oh God, that you just touch the families of this land, Jamaica. Lord, right now, in the name of Jesus, oh God, that they'll represent each sector, oh God, wherever they are. Lord God, they'll be represented well. Lord, I pray for the families represented in this church. Oh God, that will be that example that others will see, oh God, and say, Lord, I want to be like them. Lord, help us, oh God, Lord, to just look to you. Oh God, Lord, I pray this morning for the sick, those who cannot come to church for whatever reason. Lord, those who are in the hospital bed this morning. Lord, but we are here standing. Oh God, we thank you, oh God, for that, oh Father. But in the midst of our health, oh God, Lord, I pray for those who are feeling sick this morning. You are the great physician, oh God, and I know that you can do exceedingly abundantly above all that we may be able to ask or think this morning. Lord, I thank you, oh God, for this church. Lord, I thank you for this plot of ground that you have placed us on this morning. Lord Jesus, I pray, oh God, that we'll be that beacon. Oh God, we'll be that example, oh God. Lord, that we'll speak the word and speak the truth only. Lord, I pray, oh God, for our pastor and his family. Lord, I pray that you'll continue to
strengthen him, oh God. Strengthen the members of this church. Lord, strengthen each individual, oh God, each ministry. Oh God, I pray, oh God, that you continue to bless us indeed and enlarge our territory this morning. Bless this service, Father. Show up in a new way, oh God. Do something that you have never done before in this service, God. Lord, you, God, will do what you are supposed to do, oh God. You are welcome in this place, mighty God. You are welcome in this place, Abba Father. Lord, you are welcome, oh God. Show up, oh God. Touch someone's life this morning. Lord, heal someone this morning. Lord, save someone this morning. Lord, lift us up this morning. And when we have left this place, Lord, we would have said it was good for us to have been here. Bless the speaker in a mighty way. Lord God, show up, oh God, the word, oh God, that will come forth with clarity. Lord, that someone's life will be transformed. Someone will be blessed this morning. And Lord, as we try to enjoy the rest of this season, be with us, oh God. Be with us and help us to remember that you are the reason for this season. Thank you, Lord, for hearing our prayers, oh God. Lord, thank you, oh God, for answering in advance. Lord, that may the words of our mouth and the very meditation of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, oh Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Lord, what I said, ask of you right now, say not grant it according to your will, as I tell you thanks and that we love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. As we give those who are outside a chance to come in, let us get ready for this morning's scripture reading. And this will be taken from Isaiah 9, from verses 1 to 7. And this will be done by our brother Laval Lester. Can we invite him to come at this time? And as soon as he's here, you may stand for the reading of God's holy word.
Morning, everyone. So again, today's scripture reading will be taken from. Yes, this morning's scripture reading will be taken from Isaiah 9, verses 1 to 7. Please follow through as I read. Nevertheless, the dimness shall not be such as was in her vexation, when at the first ye lightly afflicted the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali, and afterward did more grievously afflict her by the way of the sea, beyond Jordan, in Galilee of the nations. The people that walk in darkness have been a great light, have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. Thou hast multiplied the nation and not increase the joy. They joy before thee according to the joy in the harvest, and as men rejoice when they divide the spoil. For thou hast broken the yoke of his burden, and the staff of his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, as in the day of Midian. For every battle of the warrior is with confused noise, and garments rolled in blood. But this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Seven and last, of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end upon the throne of David, and upon his kingdom to order it, and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even forever. The zeal of the Lord of his hosts will perform this. Here endeth a portion of God's holy word. Honored by saying.
Mr. Engineer, the main microphone, just turn up this. And we're not hearing the monitors up here.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It is time to stand up and praise the Lord. It's Jesus' birthday coming soon. So we're going to... Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, so we're going to give him some extra praise this morning. So we're going to stand up and give him our all as I welcome the praise team. Hallelujah. 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 As we welcome the praise team to come at this time.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Psalm 150 says, praise ye the Lord. Praise God in the sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Hallelujah. Praise him for his mighty acts.
Hallelujah.
Praise him according to his excellent greatness. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and the harp. But verse 6 declares, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. And everybody in here this morning, we are alive and well. Come on, let us magnify the name of the Lord this morning.
Hallelujah.
He is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah, somebody. Hallelujah. It is nothing good that we have done. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us give him the highest praise. Hallelujah. 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 He's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Let the glory of the Lord. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Oh, let it rise. We sing, oh, oh,
let it rise.
Let the glory of the Lord. Glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Let the glory. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. We sing, oh,
oh,
we sing, the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Let the glory of the Lord.
glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. We sing, oh,
let it rise. Oh,
let it rise.
Hallelujah. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Hallelujah. 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 Don't try to tell me that God is dead. You know why? He woke me up this morning. Hallelujah. I'm clothed in my right mind. Hallelujah. And I'm just going to magnify the name of the Lord because he's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't try to tell me that God is dead. He woke me up this morning. Don't try to tell me he's not alive. He lives within my heart. He opened up my blinded eyes and set me on my way. Don't try to tell me that my God is dead. I just talked to him.
Did you talk to the Lord this morning?
Don't
Just talk to him today. Hallelujah. So don't try to tell me that my God is dead. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's seated on the right hand of his Father, making intercession for you and I. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Hallelujah. Are we happy for that this morning? Because he lives, all fears are gone. Hallelujah. Because I know who holds the future. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to do Joy to the World, the reggae version. Hallelujah. And I want you to dance in the people. Come on, man. Come on, we're going to dance in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. The word of God declares that the joy of the Lord is my strength. So even if you're not feeling well this morning, hallelujah, we're going to dance. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Majesty, worship his majesty. Unto Jesus be glory. majesty. Isn't he majestic?
Worship his majesty. Jesus who died, now glorified, King of all kings. So exalt, lift up on high the name.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We exalt you.
As I invite the praise team to come back and let us do O Come, let us adore him.
O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him. In Christ the Lord.
to invite our host pastor, the Reverend Ewart McDonald, to come with the welcome. Rev.
Indeed, we live to worship and to honor our God, our Father and friend. And we really want to give God thanks for this opportunity, for this time that we gather like this, to give glory and honor and praise. Yes, Jesus Christ came as a babe in the manger, but today he is no longer a babe in the manger. He's a reigning king. He's seated at the right hand of God, making intercession, pleading our case and our cause. Could somebody put your hands together in celebration of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, and our King. Let me say welcome to one and all, my happy privilege to do so. And if you have joined us on the World Wide Web for the very first time here at the Greater Portmore Open Bible Church, we say welcome to you. Those who are in person, if this is your first time worshiping with us here at the Greater Portmore Open Bible Church, could you be kind enough to stand right where you are? Just stand. First timers, all right, please, could we put our hands together for all our first timers? Could we give them a better hand than that? Praise be to God. We're indeed happy to have you worshiping with us. Just remain standing until you're visited by one of our friendship persons. We really want to give you, we're happy to have you worshiping with us. Praise be to God. Those persons who are celebrating or recently celebrated a birthday, we want to celebrate with you. All right, Kaylee. Please, all our birthday celebrants, please stand. Please, put your hands together for them. Give them a better hand than that. Praise be to God. Please, we'll take our birthday song. We'll take our birthday song at this time. Happy birthday. Birthday, and may God bless you and continue to keep you. You may be seated. Those who are celebrating, recently celebrated a wedding anniversary, we want to celebrate with you. Please. Excitement. Lots of excitement. All right. So we'll start here. Deaconess Humes, Mr. Humes, how many years? How many years? 6 years. Could you put your hands together for the Hughes? Really, really celebrating. Keep standing. Ella Brown, how many years? 27 years. Please. Sister Celia, wave to us. 27 years. 28. Yes, Ella Brown says 27. Is it? It's all right. Don't worry. Let me tell you something. As marriage officers, when we do the wedding, after the wedding, there is a certificate. We normally give it to the bride, because they say women will keep the dates, you know, a little more careful. So we understand Ella Brown. I mean, and thank God Sister Celia Brown is back. Yes, put your hands together for her. Really, 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 really happy. Please. And Deacon Lewis, how many years, Deacon Lewis? 8 years. Put your hands together for 8 years. Please, Mr. Music, take it away. Play that one, please. You can play that one? Yeah.
Together for all those who are celebrating wedding anniversary. We celebrate with you, and may the hand of God continue to bless your marriage and your family. You may be seated. God bless you. Those who we have some returning residents. Please, Sister Donna Smith, who else has come back from foreign, just stand and give us a wave. And please, just stand. Yes, stand again. Really, really happy to have you back. Put your hands together for all those. Right. Please, we celebrate with you. May God bless you and continue to keep you. Anybody who was away for a little while, they went to rural Jamaica. No, so we're all here. We really, really want to. On a different note, our brother Merrick Wong lost his brother this week, and we want to. Do we have any other person in the congregation that has lost a relative this week, sometime in recent time? All right. Well, Brother Wong, we convey to you, Sister Wong, and the rest of the family, our deepest sympathies and regards, and our prayers are with you. And as the details become more available, then we'll pass on save to you. Let us pause our prayer at this time for those who lost their loved one at this time. Let's pray. Our Father and our God, our friend, you have invited us to come boldly to the throne of grace. And so, Lord, we put our brother Merrick Wong, Sister Wong, and the family at this time, as they have lost a family member. You promise that you'll never leave us nor forsake us. You promise that you'll be with us until the end of the age. And so, Lord, we ask that you will comfort them at this time, be with them in a very special way. We give you thanks and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Those on the inside, you can come along. You know, brethren, we had said that we want to put on the other door on the building on the other side by Christmas. Yeah? Go ahead, put your hands together. So we're not only saying it, but we're working, isn't it? Yes. There's a song that says, "Celebrate, Jesus, celebrate." I think we should sing that song, praise team. Celebrate Jesus, celebrate. Let's do that song. We really want to give God thanks. And we tell you a little more about the celebrate Jesus, celebrate.
Celebrate Jesus, celebrate. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. Amen. Celebrate Jesus, celebrate. Celebrate. Forevermore.
strike them for the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise be to God. May be seated at this time. Please continue to enjoy the rest of the service.
Hallelujah. We are celebrating. We have a reason to celebrate, right? The resurrection of our Lord. Hallelujah. At this time, I would like to invite our sister Julian Smith with an item. Can we put our hands together for her? Let's keep the applause going to encourage her as she comes. Sister Julian Smith.
Brother, and his name, all of praise.
Thank you, Sister Julie. Oh, night. Oh, holy night. At this time, I would like to invite our Sister Kimberly Wright with this morning's announcements. Sister Wright?
Good morning, everyone. These are the announcements for December 24, 2023. Open Bible Standard Churches of Jamaica believes. We believe in the Bible. We believe the Bible to be the inspired word of God and accept the same as the infallible guide and rule of our faith and practice. The Bible foretold the place of Christ's birth according to Micah 5 verse 2. This was fulfilled 700 years later, that he was to be born of a virgin, Isaiah 7 verse 14, and the kind of ministry he would have, Isaiah 61, 1 to 2. Regular announcements. Please join us for Sunday School for All Ages, discipleship class, for children, young people, and other persons who desire baptism. There is also a membership class for those who are desirous of membership right after service. There will be no Bible study this Tuesday, December 26. We will resume on January 2, 2024. The church meets for Mountain Movers prayer meeting every Thursday at 11 a.m. You are invited to attend if you are available, as remember, prayer changes things. If you are unable to attend, you may place your prayer request in the box right here or at the back, the wall at the back right there. Youth meetings are held at church every Fridays except Fifth Friday at 7 p.m. Christmas morning service will be tomorrow at 7:30 a.m. Watch night service will be held on Sunday, December 31st, 2023 at 9:30 p.m. Youth and young adults, here's an opportunity to join the youth choir. If you're interested, please speak to Sister Jodian at the back there after service. There will be baptism on the fifth Sunday, that's December 31st, immediately after the morning service. Please continue to drop off your plastic bottles in support of the Women of Word Recycling Project. We continue to encourage you to donate to the love box or barrel right over there. Take a tin, a box, a case, or a pack of non-perishable items. They'll be distributed accordingly. A very special thanks to the persons who have been donating. We continue to be grateful for your financial gifts that includes your tithes, offering, love gifts. Please continue to remit same via online or ABMs and the banking information, National Commercial Bank, University Branch, 401, the number 401-094-431. That is 401-094-431. Once you have done this, we ask that you submit the receipt that you get to greaterportmoreob@gmail.com. Please remember to pray for the bereaved families or nation leaders and sick and hurting. And we have a Christmas suggestion for you. To your enemy, forgiveness. To an opponent, tolerance. To a friend, your heart. To a customer, service. To all, charity. To every child, a good example. To yourself, respect. God bless you. Thank you, Sister Kimberly. At this time, I invite any babies to be dedicated. Please come forward at this time. Praise team.
When mothers of Salem their children brought to Jesus, the stern disciple drove them back and bade them depart. But Jesus saw them ere they
parents that have brought this little one to be dedicated. It is important that we give back these child to the Lord that He has given us. And it is really the right and the best thing to do. St. Matthew chapter 19 and verse 13, it says, "Then were brought unto him little children, that he should put his hands on them and pray. And the disciples rebuked them. But Jesus said, Suffer little children, and forbid them not to come unto me, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. And he laid his hands on them and departed thence." We want to say to the parents that are here gathered, you know, it is important that we allow the children, encourage our children to grow them in the admonition and fear of the Lord. What does that mean? Is that we teach them the word, teach them the word of the Lord, and take them, not only send them to church, but take them to church. And so we encourage you to do your level best to ensure that this little one is grown and is encouraged and is nurtured in the word. And certainly the hand of God will bless you and bless the child. Amen. Please stretch your hands towards these that have come. Our Father and our God, we thank you for this little one that has been brought to be dedicated, to be given back to you. We pray your blessing upon this child. We declare that this child has a bright future. Cover this child and keep him under your blood. And Lord, we pray for these parents. Pray for their salvation if they are not yet saved. And we commit and we commend this family to you for every blessing. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Razeri Barkley, we dedicate you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
At this time, I would like to invite our sister Jody and Erskine with a ministering item. Can we put our hands together for sister Jody and Erskine as she comes?
Good morning, everyone. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled, joyful all the nations rise, joy the triumph of the
the newborn King. Hallelujah. At this time, I would like to welcome and invite our pastor again to welcome this morning's speaker, Reverend Ewart McDonald.
Praise and glory be to our God. It is now time. Please put your hands together for our young people. It's Youth Sunday, and we celebrate our young people. Boy, I was reminded that Brother Anthony Abba lost his mother-in-law. And so when you call names, you can sometimes. But let me say publicly, Brother Abba, and to you and your family, if you're watching, you have our deepest condolences and sympathies as a congregation, and we are praying for you and your family at this time, and may the hand of God comfort and keep you throughout this difficult time. Amen. Anybody has lost a relative? All right, let's proceed. It is now time for the spoken word, and God always have a word for his people. Our speaker this morning has been married for 20 years. Theologically, he was the prepared at Jamaica Open Bible Institute. He pastors the New Life Open Bible Church, serves as one of the board of directors, Open Bible Standard Churches of Jamaica, actually in the capacity of the Eastern Regional Superintendent, an evangelist locally and internationally. Please help me welcome brothers and sisters, the Reverend Marcus Williams. Put your hands together and welcome the man of God as he comes to bring you, Reverend Williams.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let us go to the Lord in prayer this morning. I'm going to invite you all to pray with me. Let us pray together. Everybody, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning in the name of Jesus Christ, the name that is above every other name. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. This morning, Father, we humble ourselves under the mighty hands of God, and we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, giving you honor, giving you glory, giving you praise, worship, and adoration for all that you have done and that which you're doing now and that which you're getting ready to do. Lord, it's not by our might, neither by our power, it is by your spirit. Lord, you have kept us throughout 2023. God, in the last month of this year, we want to say, Lord, thank you. We are filled with gratitude this morning, Lord. Many have died and gone, did not see today. But Lord, we are here. And we know that it has been your grace and your mercy that has brought us through. This morning we honor you, we praise you, and we give you worship. I now take authority over this atmosphere. I command every spirit that is not of God to leave right now. In the name of Jesus, I say let God arise and let his enemies be scattered in Jesus' name. I pray for those who are sick. I pray for those who are depressed. I pray for those who are oppressed, those who are battling severe illnesses. I command them to be healed in Jesus' name. Lord, take full control. Lead and direct in the service. It is all about you. In Jesus' name we pray. Can the church say amen? Anybody brought a praise this morning? Anybody brought a praise this morning? Let me hear your praise. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Can you stand with me if you will? Lift up holy hands and bless the Lord. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Help me praise him this morning. He's high and lifted up. Somebody shout unto the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. 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 Give the Lord a praise. Give the Lord praise this morning. He's high and lifted up. There is no God like our God. Man could search all over
still couldn't find the one like you. Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Somebody praise him. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him for his goodness. Praise him for his mercy. Praise him for his faithfulness. Let everything that have breath praise thee, the Lord. Worship the Lord. Hallelujah. We worship you this morning. You are holy and high and lifted up. We bless your name. We bless your name. Oh, hallelujah. Clap your hands for the Lord. Take your seat in the presence of God. Hallelujah. I want to greet our pastor this morning, the Reverend Ewart McDonald, his family, and the ministry team here at Church of the Open Bible, Greater Portmore. A big God bless you. Hallelujah. The scripture has already been read from the book of Isaiah chapter 9, reading from verse 1 through the verse number 7. But I want to read something from Isaiah 7 and verse number 14. The Bible tells us, therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel. Emmanuel, which means God with us. What I love about the book of Isaiah is that the author, Isaiah, he earned the name the Eagle-Eyed Prophet based on how far in the future he could see. He looked in the realm of the spirit and he saw that the virgin would be with child. This prophecy came about after 700 and odd years before this prophecy came to pass. A lot of people don't understand how important the birth of Jesus Christ really is. And it is very sad that sometimes we only preach about the birth of Christ during this time. But I want us to understand how important the birth of Jesus Christ really is. And as such, I want to share 3 quick points with you as it relates to the birth of Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ was born, number one, salvation became a reality. Salvation became a reality. In Matthew 1 and verse 18, the Bible tells us, now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise, when as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. And even though Jesus was born of Mary, he was a child of the Holy Ghost. As I was preparing this message, the Lord began to speak to my spirit. I know that many of us this morning, we know our biological parents. But the sad thing is there are some who don't know your biological parents. But you are a child of God. I'm here to tell you, your mother and father might have came together for you to be born. But you are a child of the Holy Ghost. You are a child of the Most High God. That's why the Bible said, when my mother and my father forsake me, then God will pick me up. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. So it was through Mary, he put on flesh and blood, the human nature, taking the likeness of the flesh. But Jesus was a child of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. In Matthew 1 verse 21, the Bible tells us, and she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Salvation became a reality. Hallelujah. I want somebody to know this morning that this Jesus Christ who was born, he shift everything, hallelujah, to God when he came to earth. Hallelujah. The Bible said that when the fullness of time was come, God sent forth his son. I don't know about you, but when I pause to think, had he not come to this earth and died on the cross and rose from the dead, where would I be today? I have to pause to give God the glory. His name shall be called Jesus. And I want to say to you that there is only one Savior. There is only one Deliverer. There is only one who can set you free. His name shall be called Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sin. We were born in sin and shaped in iniquity. If there is any road that we are all familiar with, is the road called sin. But Jesus Christ came into this world. He knew no sin. He did no sin. In him was no sin. But he became the sin bearer to redeem man to God. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Because he was born, my salvation became a reality. Hallelujah. If there is anything else that I'm happy about this morning, it is not because I own my own home. It's not because I own my own car. It is not because we are able to provide for the family. But my greatest accomplishment is that I'm born again. Salvation has come. Hallelujah to my house. It doesn't matter what you own. It doesn't matter what you possess. If you have not Christ, you have nothing at all. But if salvation has come to your house, that's enough to give God glory. That's enough to give God praise. That's enough to give God worship. Salvation has come. Oh, glory to God. We give you worship this morning. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody praise Jesus. Somebody lift up holy hands and bless the Lord. Ah, shakatalaman delibusai. Jesus in the Greek is equivalent of the Hebrew name Joshua, which means Jehovah the salvation, Jehovah the Savior, or the salvation of Jehovah. So hence, Jesus is not only man, but God. Not only Jehovah, but Jehovah becoming our salvation. Thus, Jesus is our Savior. And I know about you, but we needed to be saved. And there was nobody else who could have come and saved us but him. Not Abraham, not Isaac, no, not John the Baptist, not Isaiah, not Jeremiah, only Jesus Christ. Only the sinless Savior could die for sinful man. I need somebody to understand that when you stand before Almighty God on that great day of judgment, every individual would be inexcusable, because Jesus will say, I came into this earth and I died on the cross that you can have life and have it more abundantly. This gift to human being, this gift to mankind, when the Savior was born. I'm here to tell somebody, you can be saved this morning, you can be delivered this morning. When I look back over my life and see where I'm coming from, let me talk to somebody here. I got baptized in 1999, and if I should meet up with the old Marcos from 1997 and 1998, we would not know each other. That's the power of salvation. When the blood of Jesus washes you, when the anointing of God comes upon you, when the power of God begins to work through your life. In 2 Corinthians 5 and verse 17, the Bible said, any man be in Christ is a new creature. Hallelujah. I'm here to tell you, Jamaica doesn't have an economic problem. It's not just a crime problem. Jamaica have a sin problem, because when salvation come to your house, hallelujah, your deliverance will come. Your son will be delivered. Your daughter will be delivered. Your father will be delivered. That's the power that salvation bring. Why don't you give God a praise? Give him a praise in this place right now. Hallelujah. Because of the fall of man, All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And if we say we have no sin, we make him a liar. And the truth is not in us. We all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Therefore, man need a savior. And the savior this morning is Jesus Christ. Unto us a child is born. Unto us a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulder. His name shall be called Wonderful. Counselor. Mighty God. Everlasting Father. The Prince of Peace. I'm here to tell you this morning, only Jesus Christ can save. Titus 2 verse 11, the Bible said that for the remarkable, undeserved grace of God that brings salvation has appeared unto all men. Let me read that again. For the remarkable, undeserved grace of God that brings salvation has appeared unto all men. That's Jesus Christ. Salvation, deliverance, healing, blessing has appeared unto us. Give God a praise in this place. Hallelujah. So the birth of Christ makes salvation a reality. But not only that we need to rejoice in this truth, but secondly, I want to tell you, because Jesus came, there came an end to the ceremonial law. There came an end to the ceremonial law. In Galatians 3, 23 to 29, Bible talks about atonement. And atonement is like compensation for a wrong. You all know that the high priest himself would have to offer a sacrifice for himself before he could enter the holies of holies. And then it is said that a rope would be tied around his waist. And that when he entered the holies of holies, if he should die in there, they would have to pull him out because nobody could enter. When I read about that, I also learned that before the high priest would go into the holies of holies the next day, there were holy men who sat up with him and read the scroll, read the scripture from night until morning, that his mind could be stayed on God. It was very rigid. It was very dangerous. Talk to me, somebody. Ceremonial law encompassed any rules surrounding celebrations or regular rituals regarding the temple and worship. Much about ceremonial laws, we can read these things in the book of Leviticus, how we handle offerings and priesthood and rules regarding the clean and unclean. And the first time I read Leviticus from the first chapter to the last chapter, I cried. Because I look at the office of the priest differently. Can you imagine? The man of God had to operate like a doctor under the guidance of the Lord, where he would have to say, this one is unclean, go outside of the camp for 7 days. Then by the time the thing dried up, he would have to come back, examine it again to say, all right, you can go among the people now, go back to your family. And it was such an awesome responsibility. And that's why those men were set apart. Those who serve in the temple, they were set apart. Those who were priests of God, they were set apart. And now, in 21st century, we require that same level of holiness from our men of God. We require that same level of holiness from our women of God. Yet still we put them in a secular job. You don't understand. Well, before the Lord called me into full-time ministry, there were nights when I would be driving my own truck. And I had to, before I go to preach, I had to go and before the presence of God and just ask the Lord to take everything out of me that would have picked up during the day, the conversations, different stuff that I would be exposed to. There's a different level. And that is why those who serve in the kingdom must benefit from the kingdom. And you must never muzzle the ox that treadeth the corn. I don't even know why I'm in that era right now. But somebody need to understand that the priest of God, they had an awesome responsibility. Whether you are male or female, they would have to examine you. That's why they were holy men. They were righteous men. They stayed in the presence of God. They lived in the presence of God. Their flesh was crucified and their spirit man was exalted. Give God a praise in this place. So, ceremonial law was meant to show physical representations of God's holiness and the holiness he expects from his people. The ceremonial law governed how the people were to approach God in worship. How they were to approach him. And so when the blood was demanded and blood became a requirement, it's not that the blood of bulls and calves could wash away sins, but the blood of bulls and calves would cover the sin so that the holy God could look upon a sinful people. And he said, this is a requirement. If I'm going to deliver you, this is a requirement for you to do. No, the moral law, God wanted his people to have extremely high morals that went above and beyond what other nations did. It had to be a reflection of what was right and wrong in God's eyes, not in the world. And that's why God set up ceremonial laws and moral laws. Now understand this, Church of the Living God. We don't keep ceremonial laws anymore. The ceremonial laws was given to God's people, the Israelites, how for them to live and to come before a holy God. But the moral laws of God still stand. Thou shalt not commit adultery still stand. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife still stand. Moral laws. Amen. So before Jesus came, the blood of bulls and rams could only cover the sin. But the blood of Jesus went back in time. The blood of Jesus is for now. The blood of Jesus is for tomorrow. Church of God, hear me. I don't know how many persons here this morning, you have gotten the revelation on the blood of Jesus Christ. Let me tell you, when you come to the revelation knowledge of how powerful the blood of Jesus Christ really is, I don't know nothing else that could deliver me, that could set me free. Are you telling me that my sins were higher than the mountain, but the Lord sanctify me? Are you telling me that there is something so potent that it doesn't matter what the man did or the woman did? There is something so powerful that can wash you clean. The answer is yes, for there is wonder working power in the blood. Would you be free from your burden of sin? There is power in the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus not only deliver you, the blood of Jesus not only wash away your sins, but there is protection in the blood. For I hear the Bible said, and when I see the blood, I will pass over. How many are here this morning? You found yourself in a situation where all you could say was, blood of Jesus. Anybody ever been there? The accident should have taken you out, but the blood of Jesus, when the enemy come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord lift up a standard. Blood of Jesus. I don't understand what's happening in my head. Blood of Jesus. My daughter is sick. My son is sick. I'm not getting better. Well, I know something that can work. The blood. Somebody shout the blood. Somebody shout the blood. Somebody shout the blood. Say the blood of Jesus. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Give God a praise in his house. Give God worship in his house. Hallelujah. Everywhere I go, I tell people about Jesus Christ. Myself and Reverend Clayton Roberts, we were at the same car wash. And he saw me operating outside of church for the first time. We were at the car wash. There was this guy smoking. And while he was here smoking, I went over to him. I ministered to him. Said, Jesus love you. Will you repent of your sins and give your heart to the Lord Jesus Christ? He started crying. This was a guy who was smoking. He took the weed out of his mouth, put it on the floor, and he did this. We prayed for him. Let me tell you something. Church of God, when you have been delivered, you want to deliver others. When you become a disciple, you want to see others be transformed. Now, that's one of the true mark that you've been born again. You want to see somebody saved. I have a problem with persons who come to church and just sit in church and everything is all right. Each one must win one. Now, can you imagine if we have 300 people here this morning who are members of this church, and you tell somebody about Jesus Christ, that Jesus loves you, and you make sure that 2023, no matter what else I get accomplished, I'm getting one person saved. Listen, Church of the Living God, it doesn't matter. You could be a teenager, you could get your friend saved. You could make up in your mind that 2024, I'm going to get people saved. Did you know that when we stand before Almighty God, God is going to judge us as Christians? When we stand before the Bema throne judgment, God is going to say, I have given you, I gave you everything you needed to accomplish my will, but you walked away. You did your own thing, and we will be judged before Almighty God. I pray that 2024 will be a year where souls, we will carry that burden for souls. There are many persons who go to God praying for the prophetic, they're praying for the anointing, they pray for another level. I said, God, my request, my desire, give me a burden for souls. Lord, give me a burden like I've never had it before to see men being saved. We are in the last hour. This is the last days. And the church of God must be ready. We must win souls, win the lost at any cost. Shout a hallelujah in this place. I want to close this morning. Salvation became a reality. The birth of Christ, meaning that an end came to the ceremonial law. And third and finally, because Jesus was born, the power of the enemy was broken. The power of the enemy was broken. There is nowhere in your Bible where the Bible says you should run from the devil or be afraid of the devil. The Bible said resist him and he will be the one running from you. Church of God, the moment I got that revelation, my entire life changed. I realized that the devil is afraid of me. In 1 John 3 verse 8, he that committed sin is of the devil. For the devil sinned from the beginning. For this purpose the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. Amen. The devil has no power over you because Jesus Christ came and is alive in your heart. When the devil sees you, he doesn't look and see just Marcus Williams. When the devil sees you, he sees the blood. When years ago, when I used to follow Errol All, and I would go all over Jamaica, anywhere Errol All was preaching, hallelujah, there was a man who came to the tent to kill him. He came with heavy obia and sorcery, and while he was there, Errol Hall picked up in his spirit that somebody was on an assignment to kill him, and he said, the blood of Jesus is against you. And the man got up and ran out the church. He came back to visit Errol Hall the Wednesday. He said, you don't know me, but I was sent on an assignment to kill you. But when you say the blood of Jesus, I saw fire coming from your hands. I had was to run. Can I talk to somebody? The young man said, sir, every time we see somebody who is saved for real, we know it. Errol Hall said, how do you know? He said, I see them standing in a pool of blood. I'm here to tell somebody, whenever time the devil sees you, he sees the blood of Jesus. Anytime the devil sees you, why you think the devil can't touch you? Why you think the devil can't harm you? He looked at you and he said, there goes one who is born of the water, the spirit and the blood. Because Jesus Christ was born, the power of the enemy has been broken and the church has the victory. Give God a praise.
Hey, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. The devil is a liar. Hallelujah. I feel the Holy Ghost. Hey, 1 Corinthians 2 verse 8, which none of the princes of this world knew, for had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. If they had known it, they wouldn't have. Because when the devil thought he killed him to restrict, he multiplied. Jesus said, it is expedient for me to go, because if I don't go, the comforter will not come. So when Jesus Christ was crucified and they buried him, oh Church of the Living God, his time on earth walking in the flesh as a man was not over. But now he said, in a little while you will see me. He said, I'm going to manifest myself in a different way. And so while Jesus gave up the ghost, the Holy Ghost was there waiting for the baton. And the moment Jesus said, reach, the Holy Ghost grabbed that baton and touched down on the upper room. There were some people waiting in the upper room. Oh, glory to God, and the Holy Ghost came with cloven tongues of fire and sat upon every head that was present. I'm here to tell somebody this morning, the devil has no power over you. You're a child of the Most High God. You're anointed by the Holy Ghost. He said, behold, I give you power. I've given you authority to tread upon serpents and upon scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. Somebody say, and nothing. Why don't you say, and nothing? Somebody shout, and nothing shall in any wise hurt me. I'm covered under the blood. I'm covered from the crown of my head to the sole of my feet. For God has given us power to trample upon snakes and scorpions, to trample upon death. You shall not die. Rakotobaka satanabai. You shall not die, but you shall live. Sickness has no power over you. Whatever scorpions, whatever viper, shake it off and give God the glory. No cancer, no lupus, no leukemia. Every spirit of fear, every doubt and anxiety, everything in your bloodline, the doctor call it cancer, but whose report shall you believe? We overcome all the powers of the enemy. Jesus gave us power. He said, upon this rock I build my church, and the gates of hell, the powers of hell, the strategies of hell shall not prevail. Shout hallelujah. He said in Genesis 3:15, and I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. Bruise the heel on the cross. Jesus was wounded, pierced, beaten, but the NIV version said that the enemy's head was crushed. Somebody shout crush, indicating that Satan's ultimate defeat took place at the cross. At the cross, where I first saw the light and the burden, somebody give me 2 minutes, and my heart rolled away. It was there by grace I received my sight, and now I am happy all the way. Shout hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus Christ is Lord.
We got to close. Matthew 10:28. And fear not them which kill the body,
but not able to kill the soul, but rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. Ah, shakatalaman de libosa, lepakasatu raboshata. Can we stand everywhere if you can? Oh, we worship and adore you. Salvation became a reality. And end came to the ceremonial laws. Those laws none of us could keep. And him that is without sin cast the first stone. The powers of the enemy was broken. I was held up, not once, by gunpoint, at gunpoint. Should have been dead. But who God bless? When I was 19 years old, I was diagnosed with sickle cell. And I don't remember the other thing they called it, but it caused my eyes to be extremely red. And the doctors could tell you how long you live when you suffer such a sickness. Well, I'm still here. When there is a purpose on your life, no demon can take you out. I must say one last thing. Sometimes you come to church and you see your neighbor shouting. You see somebody shouting and praising God. Never judge someone's enthusiasm, because you just don't know where they're coming from. I have all right to shout. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! I should have lost my mind. I should have been dead and buried. There was a time I found myself in a situation, and I said, God, if you bring me out of this, I will serve you until I die. If I come out of this alive, I will give you my life. You would never know where somebody's coming from. And I'm here to tell you, my salvation became a reality because Jesus Christ was born. Lift your hands everywhere. Father God, let us talk to God. Everybody, everywhere. I can't hear your church. Father, we come into your presence this morning. Nothing in our hands we bring. Somebody pray. Remember those who are hurting this morning. Remember those who are troubled on every side. Not even sure which way to turn. Backs against the wall. Especially in this season. Lost a loved one, lost a family member, lost a parent, lost somebody close to them, and the mourning, the loss of a loved one, they're going through some stuff. Somebody, oh God, I pray for your people right now. Lord, may you reach down, reach down, reach down. Bend thine ear and hear us, mighty God. Lapo shatalamandelebo shata. Hear us from thy holy hill. Hear us, we pray. In the name of Jesus. We give you praise and glory. We give you honor and praise. For you are God. In Jesus' name we pray. Take your seats in the presence of God. I'm out of your way now. I want to do one quick thing before I hand over this microphone. Church of God, if I be a man of God, if I be a servant of God, I sense something in this atmosphere. That a wind of revival is pending for this ministry. I prophesy in this church today. That the membership will be receptive to this revival. For I sense the wind of God, and there is a move of God that is getting ready to take place in Greater Portmore. Somebody give God a praise in this place. My God, my God, my God. This morning, if you're not a Christian, can I pray with you?
you're not a Christian. Maybe you're a backslider. Or maybe you've never been saved before. Can you come to the altar quickly? Let me pray with you and pray for you. Is there any such person? You're not a Christian. Let me pray with you. Is there one person? I see my brother coming. Put your hands together for him. You're not a Christian, come. Salvation can be a reality today. Salvation is not a figment of the imagination. You can be saved for real. You can be delivered for real. You can be set free for real. Can I pray for three more persons? You're not a Christian. You know you're not a Christian. Come. Don't miss this morning. This could be your last altar call. Don't play around with it. Come to Jesus. Come unto me, all he that labor and are heavy laden. Put your hands together. Persons are still coming. Come unto me. Somebody else is still coming. All ye that labor and are heavy laden, God shut up and give you rest. My yoke is easy and my burden is light. Give God a praise. Shout a hallelujah. Lift up your hallelujah in this house. Shout glory in this house. Shout hallelujah. Glory to the Lamb of God. Any man be in Christ is a new creature. All things that pass away, and behold, all things become new. You can be saved today. Take it on, men of God. Take it down. Take it down. Oh, shut up. I remember when I got saved, my friends gave me 6 months. They said, you, Zibodan, you can't get saved. Well, it's 20 odd years now. I'm walking with the Lord Jesus Christ. And I can tell you that my God can save you. And not only will he save you, he has the ability to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the throne of grace. My sister, it's your time. The time to serve God is now. This is not the first time you're hearing this. This is a confirmation to your spirit that the hand of God is upon you and the Lord is calling you. It is your time. Close your eyes at the altar this morning, please. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you at the altar to repeat after me. I'm going to tell you why. The Bible said with the mouth, confession is made. Touch that lady, my brother. This lady right here. My sister, there's a strong call of God upon your life. I don't know you. I don't know you. I don't know you. But there is something that I'm hearing in my spirit. Your word is your bond. And somehow I see you coming into a covenant with God. And the Lord has kept his end of the bargain. And I hear the Lord thy God who sits high and look at low saying, what I said about you still stand. And you might have broken your end of the bargain, but God said, I still love you. And what I promise you is still for you. Will you surrender everything to him today and reactivate and recommit that which God said about you already? Somebody give Jesus a praise. With the mouth, confession is made. But with the heart, we believe. If thou shalt confess with thy mouth and believe in thine heart that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. Pray with me right now. Close your eyes. Say with me. Say, Heavenly Father, I come to you today in the name of Jesus Christ. I admit and I confess that I've sinned against you. Please forgive me. Come into my heart. Make me a Christian. Jesus, I receive you today as my Savior, as my Lord. Come into my heart as I repent. Come on, say, I repent of every sin that I have ever committed. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. I'm going to ask a question. You, both of you, you together, right? Come closer. My sister, I'm going to say something to you. My time is gone, way gone. But I want to say this to you. this man you're standing beside, I don't know. There's one thing that the Lord has given to me, and this is my gift. The Lord showed me hearts. I don't look at the faces of people. I see the heart. This man, there are dreams and visions, goals and aspirations that he has within him, and things that he wants to do, things that he will do. And God is going to release the capital that is needed to accomplish the dream and the vision that he had in his heart. You are standing beside a good man, a great man. Society is blessed to have a man like this in our midst today. Let me tell you, my sister, I'm still here in the Lord. See, there is nothing average about this unique creation that I'm looking at right now. And the Lord, as you put your hands in the hands of God, the Lord said, there is nothing that I will withhold from you. I will not withhold anything from you if you trust me, if you serve me, and if you give me everything. I look in the realm of the spirit and I see him as a minister. I see him as a man of God, a disciplinarian, somebody who will teach, somebody who will preach, somebody who will deliver others. I see young men coming to him for advice and counseling as the Lord will give him that mind. Great things are in store. Watch God work. You will know if I'm a man of God. You will see these things begin to happen. Give God a praise. Shout hallelujah. The prayer you have just prayed, the prayer you have prayed, you ask the Lord to come into your heart that make you a Christian. The counselors are standing right there. They want to take your name. They want to take your numbers so they can keep in touch with you. How do we do from here? Do we go somewhere? We go to the back. All those who came to the altar, just follow, walk with the counselors to my right. They want to talk with you. They want to speak with you. You can go with them. They want to take your names, take your numbers so we can keep in touch with you. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Put your hands together for them. Now. Hallelujah. Just before I hand over to our pastor, Reverend McDonald, I want to cover him and his family. I don't know if his wife is here. I'm not seeing Sister Brenda. She's here. Man of God, can you and your family come to the front of the church? Let me pray. The entire family, all those who are here, let me pray with you. Hallelujah. You know what I said to myself? I told my wife yesterday, I said, nothing will stop me from coming to preach this morning. I mean, I was battling the flu so hard. I mean, locked down in the room, can't go nowhere, didn't leave the house yesterday. I was battling so much. But I told my wife, I said, listen to me, there's something that God wants me to do in Greater Portmore. The Lord wants to do through me, and I have to go preach. I took my paternal multi-symptom. I did my turmeric or whatever they call it, and I'm here this morning. I trust God. Amen. Come, let me pray for you, the family, this morning. Somebody praise God. I'm going to invite the membership to stand and stretch your hands towards this family right now, the membership. Hallelujah. Father, we worship you. We're the members of the board. Members of the board from this church, can you come and stand with them? The members of the board. Members of the board. If you're a board member, come and stand with the pastor and his family. Where are the members of the board? No members of the board present today? Come. Father, we worship you. Father, we praise you. Father, we honor you. Lord, we work. Come on, church. I want you to start praying. Begin to pray right now. Let us pray for the family. Let us cover the woman of God and the man of God and their children. I can't hear the church. Somebody begin to pray. Pray for your leaders this morning. Pray that God will cover them. Pray that God will watch over them. Pray that the Lord will hide them. Intensify your prayer, church. Intensify your prayer. Somebody pray. We pray over their health. We pray over their prosperity. We pray over their integrity. We pray over their character. We bind the works of the adversary assigned to their lives in the name of Jesus. We say no weapon from against Sister Brenda. No weapon from against her daughter. No weapon from against her sons. It will never prosper. In the name of Jesus, I pray for long life and good health upon her. I pray that the wisdom that you have given unto her, the gift of wisdom and administration that you have deposited within her, I pray, God, that you may cover the gift and you may bless the woman in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I pray for your daughter this morning, God, that she will run through troops and leap over wall. I don't feel the church praying with me this morning. I bind every works of the adversary against this woman in the name of Jesus Christ. We cover her right now from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Jesus. Jesus. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Father, we cover Reverend McDonald this morning. We put your man servant before you, one whom you have raised up to serve at a time as this. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that your Holy Spirit will rest upon him. We thank you, God Almighty, that the way forward for 2024 will be given unto him. We pray like Moses. We lift up his hands that he will win the battle. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray over him right now that you shall hide him in your pavilion. You shall cover him with your blood. May you order his steps. Covenant keeping God. Covenant keeping God. Order his steps. Bless him and keep him. Use him for your glory. Use him for your glory. Raise him up in Portmore. Raise him up in Jamaica. Raise him up in the Caribbean. Intensify the grace. Intensify the anointing upon his life. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we cover their daughter with the blood of Jesus Christ. We thank you that this young lady is a force to be reckoned with. We thank you that she is covered by the blood. We thank you, dear Lord God, that her steps are ordered by God. We pray, dear Lord God, that she will not succumb to trials. She will not succumb to temptation. She will not succumb to the plans of the adversary. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray, oh God, that the pressure that she carries as a pastor's daughter to live on the example that she ought to be setting, I pray that she will never grow weary in well-doing, but you will keep her. We pray, dear Lord God Almighty, that education, academic-wise, you may bless her. She will be a force to be reckoned with. I pray in the name of Jesus that everything that she lacks, you will give it unto her in Jesus' mighty name. When I'm done, when I'm finished preaching, I want to pray for the boys in the office. I want to pray for both of you differently from here. But we cover the entire family and we bless them right now in the name of Jesus Christ. And we thank God for what he has started in the lives of this your people. Do it for thy glory, pray in Jesus' name. Somebody shout hallelujah. I want to pray for the sons. I want to pray for them in the office. God bless you. I now hand over to your pastor in Jesus' name.
There's a song that says, what a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and grief to bear. Could we sing that song?
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. Everything to God in prayer.
seated for a little while. We really want to thank God for his words to our hearts today. Is that an amen? Praise be to God. Put your hands together for the Lord. Put your hands together for our King. God always have a word for his people. Let me thank those who have joined us in the virtual space. May the hand of God bless you. And if you give your heart to Jesus Christ today and you want to reach us, you can reach us 502-5059. That's 502-5059. We'll be more than willing and happy to talk to you. We are located near the Portmore, right across from Gortuka. May the hand of God bless you, and we'll see you next Sunday morning, God's willing. 7:30 a.m. Thank you. Praise be to God. And brethren,